Hi, welcome to this training video on Simplify Surge Protection with the TVS 2660 eFuse. An industrial system needs to comply with the IEC test standards. The most commonly applied transient immunity tests are the IEC 61000-4-2. The system EST simulates the discharge of a charged human body when it gets contacted to an electronic system. The IEC 61000-4-4, the electrical fast transient immunity test, simulates the interference caused due to the inductive switching. The IEC 61000-4-5, the surge immunity, simulates the interference caused due to the atmospheric discharge such as lighting. So let us compare the power and energy levels of these three test pulses. As shown here, the surge has the highest amount of the pulse power for a longer duration. The surge pulse has an approximately 100 times higher energy than a EFT pulse train. Due to the high energy content of the surge pulse, the electronic systems can get damaged if appropriate protection circuits are not used. The IEC defines the test voltage waveform, the range of the test levels, and the test setup and the procedures. The surge open circuit voltage waveform has a 1.2 microseconds of rise time and 50 microseconds of half wave time, whereas the current profile is defined by a 8 microseconds of rise time and 20 microseconds of half wave time. The surge test also has several test levels from level 1 to level 4 along with various coupling impedance. So usually the dedicated product standard specifies the specific test conditions. A typical supply bus in a factory automation and control requires at least 500 volts 2 ohms of surge compliance. So let us take an example of a PLC CPU module which is powered from an external field power supply. So this is the power tree of this end equipment. As this equipment is powered from an external power supply, there is a need of the input protection. So the protection requirements for this end equipment are the input reverse polarity protection, which could happen due to the input side field miswiring, the overvoltage protection due to the external field power supply, the overcurrent protection, and the reverse current blocking during the supply voltage interruption test. So along with these protection requirements, there is also a requirement of protection during the surge test. As this end equipment is powered from an external field power supply, the input ports undergo the IEC test suite. So let us discuss about the surge performance of a TVS diode and its implications for the system. Can a TVS alone protect the system, or do we need more protection? So let us talk about the surge performance of a TVS diode. So here we consider a typical 24 volt supply system with operating voltage range of 18 volts to 36 volts. A 1.5 kilowatts bidirectional TVS is selected in this example. This shows a positive 500 volts 2 ohm surge performance on the TVS. As we see here, during the surge test, the voltage spikes to the 52 volts and then it swings down to negative 52 volts within a span of 1 microsecond. So the downstream electronics may get damaged due to this overvoltage event number 1 and due to the dynamic reverse polarity event during the surge test. So this calls for a need of an additional circuit protection. So this is the discrete implementation of the protection which is required during the surge test. This circuit is based out of a diode, LC filters, and a pass FET. The diode protects the downstream load from the reverse polarity events, and the pass FET protects the load from the overvoltage and undervoltage events. A fuse is also used in these systems for the overcurrent protection. The LC circuits slow down the slew rate during the surge test. However, this circuit is bulky and an inefficient solution. At a load current of 2 ampere, there is approximately 1 watt of power dissipation, and this increases the bore temperature. This solution has high component count. The fuse used here for the overcurrent protection is low in response, and it has a very wide current limit accuracy of plus minus 50% across the temperature. This design does not have the thermal shutdown. Here we talk about an integrated surge protection with an eFuse. This solution has all the protection features required along with the robust surge protection. This is the efficient, easy to use, and a compact solution. So this is the overview of the TPS 2660 eFuse. This device can operate from a supply bus voltage of 4.2 volts to the 55 volts DC and has an apps max of 60 volts. This has an integrated 60 volt back-to-back switches, and it does not require any additional component for the reverse polarity protection. The inrush current can be programmed using the DVDT pin. This device has a plus minus 5% current limit accuracy at 1 ampere. The current limit can be programmed using the I-limit pin. The undervoltage and the overvoltage thresholds can also be programmed using an external resistor ladder. The overload fault response can also be chosen using the mode pin. This device also has the load current monitor feature, and the iMonitor pin gives the load current information. This is the positive 500 volts 2 ohm surge performance of the TPS2660 along with a 28 volts bidirectional TPS clamp. As we see here, the load is protected from the overvoltage as well as the dynamic reverse polarity events which is caused during the surge test. And this is a large time scale waveform. And as we see here, during the surge test, the output voltage does not overshoot and does not go negative during the surge test. And once the surge test pulse is completed, the output voltage follows the input. So similarly, this is the performance of negative 500 volts 2 ohms surge on the TPS2660. So as we see here, the load gets protected from the negative voltage which occurs during the negative surge test. And once the surge pulse is gone, the output follows the input. Due to the harsh environment and exposure to threats like EST, EFT and lightning surges, industrial system is always susceptible to the catastrophic failure. Robust power circuit protection is needed in such industrial applications. As we discussed, a TVS diode alone is not sufficient. The TPS2660 eFuse along with the TVS diode offers a complete surge protection in a small footprint offering. For additional information, please visit the TPS2660 product webpage. Thanks for watching the video.